Hello everybody, Ian Robson here. Welcome back to an episode of Sosnovka. Alright, so today we're doing a little mission. I want to show you something kind of interesting that has been added to the latest version of Courseplay. So now you can use Courseplay to do the missions. Now you still need to be on the field, you can't walk away from the field, but you can use Courseplay for the missions now, which is kind of bizarre, but you're able to do it. So if you like using Courseplay for that sort of thing, you can go ahead and do that. Little note, it shows how long it's going to take to do the actual mission as well, which is kind of curious. So, it's one of the things they just added in the recent developer version of Courseplay. So, if you want to update to the latest version of Courseplay, it's the same as it was before. You have to go to GitHub and do all that stuff in order to get the latest version of it. So, so far I've been pretty pleased with it. It's been pretty slick, for what I can tell. It's still not as fast as doing it yourself, obviously, because look at this backing up nonsense. This is because I have turn on field. If I deactivate that, it'll just do a loop, but you may run into these trees. So that's the problem you run into. So, and they also added this other little section for Courseplay, opposite turn directions. You can do it for the last couple lanes, or you can do it for whenever possible. So I'm not exactly sure what it does quite yet. I haven't noticed a huge difference yet, but that's that. So this is what Courseplay will do in this context instead of you doing it. But you can just watch it do the work, but you can't really leave the field, because if you try to leave the field, it'll be like, oh, you're too far away from the field. See? So you still have to basically sit in the tractor and let it do its thing, but you can have Courseplay do it for you. So if that's your thing, you could do that. Is it cheaty? That one. It's funny. There's a huge debate over using GPS for this type of stuff and whether or not that was cheating or not. A lot of people found that using GPS to fertilize the field was cheaty, and this is even worse, I think. Like, obviously, this is. I don't even have to do anything in this context. I don't even have to turn. I could just stand outside the tractor and watch it do its work. Now, that's the bizarre part, but you know. If you wanted to just let it do its thing for, you know, however long, you could easily do that. So here's what it does when it turns outside the field as opposed to on the field. Is it gonna get back? I'm not too worried about if it fails. Oh, just barely. But that's what it'll do if it turns outside the field. So that's turn on field deactivated. But it's a faster turn, but you do need quite a bit of space to do it, so. And you can reduce the turning circle, so it's down to like 5 meters, something like that. So it'll do a smaller turn circle. And sometimes that'll make a big difference when you're trying to, you know, avoid a tree, for example. So, that's something to consider, something to think about. So if you want to use Courseplay, this is only available the latest version of the developer copy of Courseplay. So you won't be able to get it with, I think it was version 00045. And this one is 00047. So now that's what happens when you have them turn outside the field. If it's turning on the field, what will happen is you'll back up and do the turn. So, but just to give you the idea of what you can do with it now. A couple of people left a comment saying you could do this, which I thought was kind of interesting. That it was a possibility now. There we go. And you could always use your GPS too, which I think GPS is a bit, for this type of stuff, I think GPS just works just a little bit better. Because the way you turn is way faster than the computer can turn. So that was the one thing to keep in mind when you're messing around with this. So like, just do a quick little turn. You don't even need to turn off your slurry spreader in this context. And you can just do that. So it's pretty easy. The funny thing is like when you think about this, like this is what you would use GPS in real life. Because you're doing a mission here. But using Courseplay, I don't know. Like, I guess the one context where I would think Courseplay might be fine to do that with might be when you will have like a long mission and you can't finish it because you have to do something else. Like, maybe that would be a situation where it might make sense. But even then, some people wouldn't feel very comfortable doing that. Oh, we're coming up to our... we may not finish this mission. That's funny. Now, I just wanted to show you that. I probably won't use it very much because I think it is a bit overkill. GPS I'm okay with because you can't get out of the tractor and let it do its thing. You have to actually be in the tractor. But with course play, you can actually just walk out of the tractor altogether. And that's kind of where I draw the line, I guess. There we go. Finish off that. Spread a little bit of slurry. We should be able to finish this. That was pretty close, though. That's what I get for messing around. There we go. Almost done, as we can see up there. Just going to have a quick sip of lovely second cup coffee. Well, it's second cup in the sense that it's the second cup I've had this morning. Not like from the actual store. Excellent. A little bit of extra money never hurt us. Also, another little random point, if you didn't know this. So one of the things you can do is in this these options right here, you have help refill fertilizer, slurry, and manure. So these ones I'm looking at, the slurry and manure. So what you can actually do is change it. So instead of buying slurry, he uses it from the slurry tank at the cows, or the pig slurry, or the biodigestate at the BGA, which is awesome. Same thing with manure. Cow manure heap, pig manure heap, and I think that's it. So if you want to use the manure out of your cow manure without having to like go back there every 20 seconds and refill, you can totally do that now, which is crazy. Anyways, we're going to take care of a little bit more of this tree. I may do part of this tree on camera. Not all of it, I don't think. They are quite a pain, though, these big, tall trees. Now, there's always a way around this. I did find that there was the beast is back. I don't know if you ever used the beast, but it's basically like a huge trailer. Timber! Oh, look at that. It's like a huge trailer, basically, that you were able to basically just dump the whole tree in, which is kind of crazy. I'm not going to be able to get that. Maybe not from here. But it was pretty nuts what you could do with that thing. Really? There we go. I just want to like half crouch. There we go. So, yeah, it was a cool little trailer. And there's always the one I used to use for chipping stuff. There we go. Let's grab that. Object is too heavy. Oh, wow. Again. So, I don't know if, I don't think that's too heavy. I think you'd be able to pick that up. In my opinion, at least. Let's grab all the rest of this here. That's what I call lumberjack walking. So, the funny thing is, so if you have the game extension installed, you can always come in and increase your strength, so you could have Herculean strength. And you could pick up the whole tree, which is probably just as cheaty as using course play for missions. But oh, look at that. I wasn't even trying to do that. That's awesome. Yeah, this is the reason why I don't like chipping stuff, or I don't know, it's a lot better than it used to be, that's for sure. It used to be just horrendous, in my opinion at least, but I don't like logging in general, so I'm a little biased, I guess. There we go. Pick it up. Really? That didn't go in? So, what we'll do is we'll start on that side. There we go. Apparently that's not quite... There we go. So the hard part about these is you can actually get these huge tree trunks in the chipper, but you have to make sure that you cut you cut awfully close to the actual tree trunk itself. Because I've discovered that if you leave too much, basically, on the sides, what will happen is it just won't go in. It'll get stuck. Let's cut a little piece off there. There we are. So as you can see, I have $75,000, and that is from selling the silage bales that you saw in the previous episode. So that is what that's all about. And I had a suggestion in the last episode to buy a new field. I don't know if we have enough money to buy a new field quite yet. Let's see. So yeah, the big thing I'm trying to do is trying to get as close to the actual tree trunk itself, the main part at least. So and can I grab that? I'm assuming not. Let's get that little part there. As you get used to the way the trees handle, it's not as bad, because then you realize what you can and can't do basically. I still prefer farming over it, but once in a while it's not so bad. Especially in this kind of situation where it's for the eventual purpose of more farming. There we go. Let's do that. Go to the other side here. I wish that works too. There we go. Object is too heavy? I didn't ever would have thought that. There we go. Let's see if we can get this little piece here. We'll delim this and then we'll do something else. There we are. Take a chunk over here. Probably still won't be able to lift it up anyways. Let's see. Oh, I can do that one. That's cool. I didn't think I was going to be able to get that. So, yeah, someone suggested to get a new field, so what we're going to do real quick here is take a look at some new fields in a moment here. There we go. Sure, throw it over there. That's where it's going anyways. There we go. Or don't. Am I really stuck behind this tree? I totally am. Let's grab it from this side, and then... There we go. Perfect. Alright, so we got a couple more limbs to go here. Is that close enough? I think so. Yeah, like I said, the hard part is trying to get the whole... Get it close enough so the limb... Get it close enough so you can actually just stick the whole tree in there. Because before you couldn't do that. Well, if you leave too much of a trunk off the side, you won't be able to. There we are. Get this little chunk right here. It's bizarre how the trees fall sometimes. It doesn't make sense. But hey, it's Farm Sim, so sometimes things don't need to make sense, I guess, right? So, alright. There we go. It's not getting pulled in. Let's see here. I think we'll stop there for the time being for the chipping-related stuff. Alright, so we have this field right here. So what we'll do is, we have a tiny little cultivator. Can we upgrade to a larger cultivator? Because we have, which one do we have? Do we have Vogel's Newt? No. Oh, I think we only have the 3-meter one. Yeah, we definitely should upgrade. And our tractor is a 224 horsepower tractor. Okay, good. Let's upgrade our cultivator to something a bit more. No, that's too big. So is that. So is that. So is that. And I don't want to use those. This is from the Lemkin pack on the mod hub, actually, which is pretty good. Let's see here. 5 meters. 6 meters. That requires, that's 5 meters, 6 meters, and that one is 6 meters, 230. That's getting close to our maximum. Or we could use this 6 meter one, which is 180, or this, let's try the Lemkin one. I haven't used this one before. 6 meters, 220. That's just on the hour, just on the edge of it. And is that a 3-point hitch? A cultivator prepares field for next seedbed combination for use of plow and cultivator. Twin wheels back and front with our recommendent. I don't know, that looks weird. It looks like that goes on something else. Maybe I will, because it looks like, yeah, those are weird. Because I think those are actually supposed to go on this thing here. That's why I'm a bit reluctant to buy it now that I look at it. And that's 230 horsepower. That's 190. I want the 6 meter one though. All right, let's get that one. And that's 50 grand versus 52 grand, and that's too big. Well, let's do this then. That's like 20 grand more. This is, that's a no brainer now that I look at it. The other one was like 20 grand more for the same width, so. All right, let's take a little drive down there. We'll grab our cultivator here. At the same time, we can take a couple items down to sell. Yeah, those big trees just take a lot of time to like delimb and set up properly, so it's always a pain. I fertilized all the fields here and got all the I got all of the silage bales off there. Not as many as I would have liked. I think I didn't fertilize them twice. All right, so we're gonna take this little guy here, because I don't want to use this little thing anymore. There we go. And I can grab this cedar here. No, not like that. Alright, so what we'll do is we'll just reset it, because where can I grab the trailer from this side? No. Let's just do this. This guy's attached to it still, I think. Alright, let's grab the trailer. Just move out of the way for the time being. There we are. Go into the next bay, basically. There we are. Perfect. And oh, let's grab that one little. And we'll sell both of these and get rid of them because basically at this point they're just using up our maintenance costs. Alright. Take a quick little jaunt. Look at that, it's actually set to go to the farm. Sweet. Let's see what it does. A big circle, apparently. Oh, there it goes. So, we actually have a couple things. Well, that's kind of neat. I never noticed that. You guys ever seen that before? Look at that. That's like dust in the lamp. Huh. So, anyways, this field has been fertilized, and all the fields have been fertilized already. I think actually we may have some. Yeah, canola is still a good price. Well, it's even better there. And I think that's the only thing we can really sell. Oh no, we have barley too. That's a decent price, and I think that's it. Wool has gone up in price again. So this is good for us. So what we'll do is we'll let that guy do. Let the tractor go to the shop, and then we'll sell those, and pick up the Vogelsnoot and do a little bit of cultivating, I think. I haven't decided whether to change this field over to a grain field again or not. Not sure about that. Because right now, basically, our... I wonder how that happened. Right now, our combine has been sitting almost idle. Well, I guess not. I guess we've been working on field 23 for the time being, so... we should probably check on our cattle. I haven't looked at how they're doing. I think they're still okay. Yeah, they're still fine. They're still good. Oh, perfect. Look at that. Alright. Let's go ahead and sell these items. Because we do not need them. Not anymore, at least. There we go. And let's sell the cultivator. Good. And oops, don't know why we did that. The little box is right over here. All right, sell and sell. Yes, please. We'll grab the Vogel's Newt. Someone was saying there actually is a in one of the mod hubs mods. There's actually one of the mods you can get does like plowing and cultivating. I think it was actually that Lemkin set that does it, because if you look carefully, it'll say plowing, cultivating, so. Alright. This is like the go-to cultivator to start off. I think I can upgrade this tractor. Let's see. What's the engine upgrade? I think it goes up to 260. It wants to upgrade the... why does it want to upgrade that? It's not even in the box. Anyways, I think it goes up to 260 if memory serves. This should definitely increase the speed at which it takes to do things. Now technically our seeder is a direct seeder, so we could always just direct seed, but the problem with that is I have three stages of fertilization and like, would it matter? Not really. Yeah, I guess the third stage would have to be like when the plants are fully grown. And that would be that one time when you do it. Alright, 1 second. Grab a sip of coffee again. Alright. So, the cool thing about Courseplay is you can do everything with Courseplay. Anything you really want to, except for cultivating, plowing. Now, a couple people have been asking comments like how to set up a cultivator with Courseplay. I think I actually have a video on that already, but I can show you guys right now. Pretty straightforward. So, let's clear the course here. So you need to be in field work mode, and this is 23. So let's go ahead and select 23 from our list. And this is a 6 meter, and I want to go just below 6 meters. So there's a little bit of overlap. Starting in the northwest corner, heading east, turn to the first point. Yes, please. Do a headland, no. Generate the course, and we'll save this as F23 culti 6 meter. There we go. And let me just back up here a little bit, because the starting point is going to be right there. There we are. And then drive to the first waypoint. And then just gonna start cultivating. That's how you do it. It's pretty straightforward, actually. Let's grab this guy right here, because we may need to move some of that stuff at the end, I realize now. Alright, so let's go over to the end of our line here. Now, I haven't looked, but apparently people have been telling me the headland feature actually works now, but I honestly haven't tried. So, keep that in mind, I guess. Should you wish to try it, by all means. It's funny, it looks so foggy outside. It's like a dark, dreary gray day. That's what it is. All right. Is that gonna be in the way? Oh yeah, definitely. Maybe not the first pass, but after that it will be. So let's grab the trailer here. This is actually almost full anyways. How full is this trail? I think it's close to 100%, maybe 50, 60, 70, wow, okay. Okay, well maybe we'll finish up with some of these limbs here so we can get a full trailer's worth, and then it becomes worth it to move out of the way. Let's see, what's the best way to do this? There we go. And the reason why I'm doing this, of course, is like I said, just get a full trailer. Whoa, easy. A little bit closer. It's funny, there's a YouTuber I watch. He is a fisherman. And he always says, take it easy to the fish, which is hilarious. Oh, is this not on anymore? No, of course you're not. Why would you be on? There we go. Yeah, he always says take it easy. It's pretty funny, actually. I find it comical, at least. Some people say he exaggerates a bit much. I mean, that's definitely true. He definitely exaggerates, but that's part of what makes it funny. Okay, I'm pretty sure I can pick that up. I'd be surprised if I couldn't. Let's see, aha. Can we get that little piece there? There we go. Good. And that's going to be way too heavy for us. It'd be awesome if I could pick it up, but no. Let's grab this, just throw it in the field. Sure, why not? Actually, a lot of farmers do bush work in the winter and sometimes in the fall, just depending on what they got going on. Come on. There we go. There's that. And let's grab this piece here. Like I said before, like once you get used to it, it's not too bad to kind of do it. You get quicker at it to delim trees and whatnot. It's still a pain. It's like, why isn't that getting pulled? I don't know, but it's not for some reason. Come on. There it goes. Alright, let's chop this one in two, and that probably will be a full load's worth. Excellent. Let's put that in there. Good, and I think we can pick up this one too now. Excellent. Wait, it's so light now, we can just toss it around. Really? Things don't just fly around like that. Alright, here we go. This time. And then that cut up into smaller pieces, and that should be alright to get in there. Alright, so let's turn this off real quick. And let's grab the tractor here. 85%, it's not so bad. And let's take a little jaunt down to the biomass heating plant. How does that look together? It's not terrible. Maybe with the narrow tires it looks a bit odd, but other than that, it looks alright. If I had like regular tires on, it'd probably be fine, but I don't know, like these trees don't you get a little bit of wood chips from them. They don't seem to make as much as some other things do, so. Someone was saying you can use the scorpion on those trees that I was working on, which is definitely not true. I definitely tried that. I'm like, hey, maybe they changed it. I'm like, no, definitely not. Definitely not. It would be pretty awesome if they did, though. So, all right, more coffee. All right, so where is that biomass heating plant? So I need to go straight through this roundabout here, and then it's going to be on my right. Could put my lights on, I suppose. Well, it doesn't really seem to make a difference. Not in the gray, rather, here. There we go. There's another truck. Looks like a gas truck, a GAS. And here is the biomass heating plant. And here is our little stop for wood chips on Sosnovka. There we go. Make a little bit of money from that, which is always nice. Not a lot, actually. I don't find wood chips are the most... not usually the most productive things. They have their moments, though. If you want to drop off logs, it's right there. So we made 6,000 from that. I still haven't found a John Deere skidder yet. I don't know if that has come back to Farm Sim 17, because in 15 they had a John Deere skidder, which was awesome. Because he's dragged the whole tree. There we are. It's funny, I was in Montreal this weekend at the Montreal Auto Show, and we totally had to go in a roundabout and come out in the come out in the same direction we went in, just because we got lost, and one of the turns we made wasn't the right turn. So you basically, like, you know, because roundabouts sometimes it'll be like, you know, they're nice for turning around. Basically, I've done it before in ETS as well, where it's like, where am I going? And they're like, whoops, that's not the right way. And then you just do around, go around and around and around in the roundabout. So, anyhow, all right. So before I forget, let's take a quick look at some of the field prices here. To see if there are any that are in our price range. I don't know if there are any, because this big field 23 here was, it was a little bit out of our budget for a long time. I'm just gonna move this chipper out of the way before I forget here, because you can move this chipper. You can drive it, but you can't turn it, which is rather annoying when you want to move it somewhere else. There we go. It's a pretty beastly chipper, though, too, I have to admit. There we go. I think that's probably good for now. So let's take a quick look at prices before I sign off. What do we got here? We got, let's check out field 20. What's the price on field 20? Oh, we can actually buy that right now. Oh, actually, yes. Yes, we can. Barely, though. And what about field 15? No, not field 15. I can probably, does this guy have, I got full reputation with this guy. So I could buy that field, and I don't know if he's the same guy as owns these ones. No, 300,000 for that. That might be a bit difficult. And what about one of these long fields over here? 97. No, we're close. We're close. I don't want to. I'm not particularly fussed about buying 15 and 20, but 25 would be nice. 28 would be nice, maybe. So this one was 300. Yeah, 300. All right, folks, that'll be it for me for today. Hope you enjoyed that episode of Sosnovka. My name's Ian Robson, and if you enjoy, why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button for some more Let's Play action. Catch you guys later.